In material design, we imagine UIs to be composed of pieces of digital paper, which we call surfaces. Now, these surfaces have tangible attributes to imply real-world behaviors, but they aren't limited like the real-world equivalents. Everything on the screen lives in one of these surfaces, including all text, icons, photos, buttons, any UI element really. Now, these surfaces have a tiny amount of physicality, just enough to show that one thing is distinct from another and how they sit relative to one another. This taps into our instinctive ability to quickly recognize objects. There's no need to take the metaphor too far and use real-world textures, sheens, specular highlights, or so on. Just the smallest set of real-world cues are enough to express a lot of meaning. Surfaces also exist in 3D space, with varying widths and heights and at different elevations. These surfaces are arranged in front of and behind one another and cast shadows on lower surfaces. So here we can see, as the fab raises up in elevation, it casts a more diffuse shadow. Let's take a small detour and really focus in about how and why shadows get cast by surfaces. In general, objects that are closer to us command more of our visual attention, and we can tell which objects are closer based on their size and how they cover and cast shadows on the things that are behind them. So we can use depth as a cue in our UI to direct attention to important elements. So how do we use these concepts on a 2D screen? We use the shadows to convey a surface's elevation relative to other surfaces. Surfaces nearer to you will cast a larger shadow. There's a lot of complicated math behind how to draw these shadows correctly, but luckily, on Android, we only have to edit a bit of code and to have the shadows drawn dynamically for us.